Hello. As you may notice, I am a bit comfy today. I'm in my Murloc onesie because it's really freaking cold outside. Well, it's starting to get pretty cold, and yeah, I don't want to turn the heat on yet, so I'm all cozy and toasty and stuff. And I was going to do a special tag video today. It was the ASMR questions video that Gibi started, and I was tagged by Frivolous Fox and also Elise. So I'm going to read all these questions and answer them for you guys. They're some of the most common questions that are asked to ASMRtists, and I'll be putting links to any of the things that I reference in the description, so make sure you check it out. Like, I'll be putting links to who tagged me, which videos I reference in this, and also who I tag at the end. Okay, let's get started. So the first question is, when was the first time that you experienced ASMR? And I have a couple to talk about. I have, the first time that I can ever remember is when I was in preschool, so I think I would have been like 4 years old or something. I can't really remember much, but the only thing I do remember is that they would have nap time for us, and all the kids would lay down on these little cots, and they would put those big box fans there, like square-shaped ones that sit on the floor. They would turn on one of those for white noise, and it would relax me so much. And then the daycare worker would come around and rub our back a little bit. Each kid got a little bit. So it was one of those kind of things that you don't get tingles from, but you get relaxation from. And the other thing that I have was in elementary school, I think it was grade 5, they had these people come and check all the kids for lice. So they had like these sticks. I remember thinking they looked like chopsticks, but I'm sure they weren't chopsticks. But these two sticks that they would like just sift through your hair gently, and like look through all the different areas, and like use the sticks to kind of pry away some of the hair, and just like dig in and look around and stuff. And like, that was so relaxing for me. I was so happy to get it done. I think a lot of the other kids really liked it too. It felt so good. And another one was just like sticks out in my mind for some reason, but the cartoon Little Bear, the show had always had like this emphasis on like the sound effects and stuff. Like whoever was the sound effects person did an amazing job, because each little sound would be created. Like I specifically remember Little Bear, he was picking blueberries. And he had a trumpet that he likes to play. And he started storing his blueberries inside of the trumpet. So when he dropped one in, it would like roll around, and you could hear it rolling and then falling into the hole. And then he would keep filling it up until it was full. But then the blueberries fell out from the bottom of the mouthpiece of the trumpet. And I just remember that whole like scene for some reason gave me that kind of ASMR feeling. Satisfaction of certain sounds. So yeah. Oh, and also when Little Bear had a marble run, so it was like he would set up all this stuff where like the marble would go through these little tracks and then like drop off onto something else and then like knock something over and then go again, and it was just like a marble track and all the little different sounds, like the sounds of it going down a metal track and then hitting a book. And it was just like so many good little sounds, and it always stuck in my head, and like I never forgot it. The next question is, when was the first time you watched ASMR on YouTube? So this was actually when I was into polymer clay, which is just like, it's a type of clay that you mold and then you can cook it in the oven and it'll turn hard so you can keep your sculptures. just really into that. So I was watching YouTube videos of people making polymer clay charms. They're just like this big, little characters and like cute things. And there was this girl, she was showing off all of her charms. She had like a big box of them. She just took out one and then put it back, and you could hear her fingers like kind of like rummaging in the box and like all the little sounds and stuff. And she was also whispering. I actually like really liked it, and I remember getting that tingly feeling in my ear because I was wearing headphones when I was watching it, and I was like, oh my god, she's like whispering right in my ear. And then I checked the description, and she's like, if you don't know what ASMR is, then Google it. And I'm like, okay. So I Googled it, and that's how I discovered ASMR. That was like many years ago, probably like 5 years ago. What's your favorite unintentional ASMR? I couldn't pick a single favorite. I can never pick one single favorite of anything. So this video is gonna have a lot of me giving you like two or three different favorites. So for this one, the first one is Evan's third marble run. It's basically just like what I explained with the Little Bear cartoon, except in real life, where his marble will go down the track, and he has all these different cool little, like, intricate ways that the marble travels and gets to its destination, and just all the little sounds that it makes. I really enjoy it, and it wasn't intentionally ASMR, but it really sounds like it for me. One is called Golden Eagle Having a Relaxing Time. And it's just a video of, I think it's Japanese, and there's this lady, and she has this big eagle on her lap, and he's laying on his back. She's just like rubbing his belly and rubbing underneath his feathers and rubbing his little legs, and every once in a while the eagle will make like a little squeak sound. And it's just like really peaceful and quiet, and they're sitting outside on the grass, and it's just like such a relaxing. One is actually really funny. It's called Hoeing in Japan 101. And it's this girl who's talking about like hoeing in Japan, like basically like hooking up with guys and stuff. But she talks really quietly in the video, and she's like, it's really soft spoken and stuff. And her voice is actually amazing for ASMR, and like I hope she makes ASMR videos. But yeah, I found that video. Like I stumbled upon it while watching
you're gonna do, you're either gonna download 10 and go from there, or you're just gonna stand outside.
My hood keeps falling off, it's quite heavy. Okay, the next question is, name the last 5 ASMRtists that you watched. So I have them down here. The last 5 use ASMR to de-stress and kind of like reduce anxiety and like bad feelings that I have during the day. So I watch it a lot in the daytime, and it just kind of helps me take my mind off things and relax and forget about the world and stuff. And then I watch it for daytime naps. So mostly in the summer when it's bright all day long, I'll take a daytime nap around like 6 o'clock or something. I'll lay on my couch with all next question is, what's the most absurd request that you've received from a fan? I don't get anything like that crazy anymore. Besides, like, of course, there's the occasional, like, creepers who are like, will you do sexual videos for me? It's like, bitch, I never said I would do anything sexual for you. But, the one that, like, stands out in my mind was from when I first started ASMR, and when you're a new ASMRtist, you get a lot of, like, fetish people that come and they're like, please make free fetish videos for me. So, the one that I remember the most was this guy who was like, he's like, I want you to make a video where you pretend that I'm a turkey, and then you kill me, and then you roast me in the oven, and then you slice me up and put me in a sandwich, and then you eat the sandwich on camera. I was like, whoa, that's like really specific. So I didn't do it. Usually if you get a request that's extremely specific, it's a fetish. That's like a heads up to any like new ASMRtist. If it's super specific, it's probably a fetish. Because it was like, it has to be a turkey sandwich. It can't be like any other kind of sandwich. Question. Do your family and friends know you make ASMR videos? So, yeah, well, my mom knows, and my boyfriend, and a couple of my close friends from high school. But other than that, like, I generally keep it quiet because I don't know anyone in real life who actually enjoys or experiences ASMR, so I don't bother, like, bringing it up to people, because if they don't know what ASMR is, then I have to explain the whole thing, and it's just like, it's a pain. Which people.